Mr. Gautam Chatterjee, our first captain of MaaRERA, Shri Niranjan Hiranandani ji, Shri Rajan Bandelkar ji, Neil Raheja ji, all the dignitaries, ladies and gentlemen. At the outset, I would like to congratulate NAREDCO for consistently supporting the constitution of MaaRERA. Right from the day central government passed the act of RERA and government of Maharashtra started working on creating the authority under this act, NAREDCO has been very active, has been supportive, and has been creating a lot of awareness amongst the real estate community. And today, I think this is the best way to make everybody aware about the new act, about the authority, about its function. And I think none other than Shri Gautam Chatterjee, who is heading the authority, is here to interact. He has already interacted and has also given replies to your questions. Although I know that there may be many more left, because whenever we migrate to something new, it's a human tendency that there always is a fear of unknown. We are mostly status quoist, and whenever there is a major shift, each one of us, including me, have a fear of unknown. What will happen? How will it happen? But let me tell you one thing. When you look at bigger problems than the problem which you are facing seems smaller. So if you can brave, survive demonetization, then what is RERA? RERA and GST are announced well in advance. Demonetization was announced suddenly overnight, and still, although each one of you struggled, but you understood the importance of demonetization. Why Honorable Prime Minister did it, every one of you knew it. Each one of us also knew that it is in the interest of the country that this is being done. So in spite of all the odds, problems which we faced, we welcomed demonetization. Even after facing difficulties, we tried to manage our finances, and here we are again standing tall. So I think so far as RERA is concerned, I must tell you two things. One is, the original act to appoint a housing regulator or real estate regulator was framed by government of Maharashtra. And when this act was introduced in assembly, all of us thought that we need a larger consensus, we need more brainstorming. So we sent it to a joint parliamentary committee, a joint legislature committee. And in that joint legislature committee, I was also one of the members. And Shri Gautam Chatterjee, being a secretary and a person who had a big role in drafting the original act, was the member secretary, because the secretary of the department has to be present there to give the replies to all the interpretations which come out of drafting. And lot of mind was put. And the only precaution which was taken that time, or the only thing on which we had lot of discussion, was we want a regulator, we don't want an inspector. So we carefully went through each chapter, each and every section of the act, and wherever we found out that this may lead to Inspector Raj, it was removed. And all this exercise were done at that time by Mr. Gautam Chatterjee. Ultimately, we sent our bill of regulator to become an act to the central government for its concurrence. Then in central government thought that they will also make it. So they never give concurrence to our bill. In fact, they said that the central government will make it for entire country. And this bill was introduced in the central parliament. It was given consent by both the houses. It became an act. So from the beginning, when it came and we thought that we should create authority, the only name which came to my mind was Mr. Chatterjee. And why? I must tell you. It is because the first authority creates precedent. And let me assure you, Mr. Chatterjee understands that a role of a regulator is more to facilitate, to have a clean trade. So he is not here to create Inspector Raj. He understands that business has to grow. He understands that we need to provide houses. And he also understands that we need to protect the consumers. So the balance, the equilibrium. And that is why when I appointed him ad hoc as a ad hoc chairman of the authority, he interacted with all the people in businesses. And I think most dynamic rules have been framed. Few states have framed different rules. But let me tell you, they are repugnant to the original act. They will not stay. They will be quashed by the court. But the rules which are made by government of Maharashtra or by MaaRERA are the one which are consistent with the act, at the same time which are more practical, where we understand that business has to grow. We don't want to create an Inspector Raj. We know that unless we give proper flexibility to the businesses, they won't be able to flourish. And real estate is one sector where the economy of Mumbai and Maharashtra gets a lot of contribution, not only in terms of tax, but also to provide houses. Housing for all is our dream. And in every endeavor, I think the real estate has a major role to play. So let me assure you that the first authority which we have created, and now I cannot claim that I have appointed him, because he is appointed by a committee headed by a High Court judge. So the entire committee also went into the merits and they found Mr. Chatterjee most suitable. But having worked together for many years, I can assure you that the MaaRERA, our authority, will ensure that all your questions will be replied, all your doubts will clear them, and we will facilitate the business so that at the end of the day you will not feel that this is a new impediment. You will feel that you are relieved. As of now, the EOW of Mumbai is more flooded with the complaints dealing with builders than about other frauds. I don't want it. It's not the job of police. It's a civil matter. It's a matter of regulator. EOW should not enter into it. But since there was no other authority available, EOW entered into it. But once you are registered with RERA, you are insulated. Those who want to do clean business are absolutely insulated. And I think most of us want to do clean business. Nobody wants to do hanky-panky things. Everybody knows that ultimately paisa kama ke karna kya hai, agar dimag ko shanti nahi hai to paise ka karna kya hai. So I think RERA is something to insulate you. If once you register, once you follow the SOPs, nobody can point a finger. And at the same time, the consumers, as of now, what is the biggest problem? The problem is of credibility. You see, this industry itself is going through a crisis of credibility. And people sometimes take disadvantage, find something technical, and on basis of that, howsoever good your name may be, but they put some allegation and try to malign you. But now, as rightly said by Mr. Chatterjee, your project, once approved by RERA, it gets credibility. Nobody can question the credibility of a project which is approved by RERA. So I think this crisis of credibility also can be put to an end through this RERA. And I'm sure each one of you at the end of the day will be happy that the regulator has come. So far as the appointed date or date of registration is concerned, I fully endorse the view of Mr. Chatterjee. So sorry, Mr. Hiranandani, although it's a NAREDCO's program and you have given me such a wonderful tea, but I'll not live up to your tea, because I think, why tomorrow? Why not today? Ultimately, at some point of time, we have to register. So let registered on the appointed date, and I think the things will be very smooth, and we are there. I'm telling you, the authority and the government, we will be absolutely lenient for 1 or 2 years on mere technical grounds. Will not allow anybody to be harassed. If there is a major glitch, that's a different thing. And if required, let's say after 6 months, if there are some practical problems, I assure you that we will look into the rules again so that such practical problems are taken care of. And I think in years' time, the ball will be rolling smoothly and we'll have no problems. Same is with GST. I know you have some problems with GST, GST rates, about certain provisions in the GST. We'll take it up with the central government. I assure you that we'll take it up with the central government. But at the same time, let me tell you that this GST regime will certainly help all businesses, because ultimately the cascading effect of the taxes, their compliances, and mostly there is no level playing field. How do you discriminate between those who are paying taxes and those who are not? And in indirect taxes, that is the biggest problem. Somebody does a circular transaction and is incurring huge profits, and somebody is tax compliant, and at the end of the day he feels that I am a fool. Why did I do this? Now with GST, we will put an end to this. We will have a tax compliant society. No more cascading effect of taxes. No more so many compliances. And again, let me tell you, it's a fear of unknown. But the GSTN, the network is designed so flawlessly. There can be certain glitches for, let's say, first 6 months. But once we also know how to go on it, how to register, how to fill our forms. And again, there is a lot of talk that there are so many compliances, so many forms. No, it's not like that. It is so sequentially done that in many cases, your reports will be self-generated. If you keep only proper records, they'll be self-generated. It's beautifully designed. And look at what business opportunity it has given. Recently, I was at a program of Oracle at Delhi, and it was before GST was even passed. It was not notified; it was just passed. And Safra Katz of Oracle was there, and she said that we are already ready with GST products. Oracle has already launched the GST compliant products so that there can be hassle-free record keeping. So this is also the readiness of the private players, the players in the field, to facilitate people. I think this fear of unknown will go away when we migrated from sales tax to VAT. It was the same. Lot of fear, because that time also I communicated a lot with the industry, and everybody was frightened. What will happen? So many compliances, such, this, that. Nothing happened. Everything was okay. We smoothly migrated to the system of VAT. Same way, we'll migrate smoothly to the system of GST. And I think ultimately, when our economy will grow, with growth of economy, I think the biggest benefiter is the real estate sector. If money comes into the economy, if the growth rate is high, if the goods and services are produced more, that pumps in money into economy. And modest figures are GDP growth by 1.5%, but the Federal Reserve of US says it can be 4% of GDP growth by GST. Imagine, even if it's 3%, even if it is 2.5%, how much of growth will we get? How much of money will be poured in into the economy? How much it will translate each and every sector of our businesses? So I think, again, on the GST, I would like to assure you that we will facilitate you, we'll help you. We'll try that your migration is smooth. We'll try to solve your problems. Government is not inspector, it's a facilitator. And in that role, I'm sure after 1 year, you'll find that there are no problems left and GST regime is working better than the VAT regime. So I think today, introduction and all the information about the GST and RERA has been given to you. NAREDCO has done a wonderful job, and I would like NAREDCO to do it more often, at least for 1 year. After every 3 months, if you organize this, we'll facilitate. Mr. Chatterjee will facilitate. Our people from housing department will come. Our people from finance department will come. We'll interact more with you so that we smoothly migrate to the new regimes. I congratulate you all for showing interest in on these issues, And I once again thank you for giving me this opportunity. Jai Hind, Jai Maharashtra.